Town News. Today we have with us the team of Noblemen. Okay, guys, welcome to Zoom. Welcome to Town News. Noblemen is a really special film. Which we saw the trailer and it's getting some really good responses. The film has already gone in so many film festivals, New York, you know. Now, what are the kind of responses that you're awaiting from the audience?
Obviously, I think the response that's most important to all of us, besides the fact that obviously audiences like the film, is that, you know, there's a conversation that starts about bullying. Because that really is the central theme of the film. And I think a big reason for all of us to agree to be part of this film was that it was dealing with an issue which hadn't been dealt before in the movies and is not spoken so much about in our society. Whereas it is an issue that, you know, really can damage the psyche of a child. So I think for us it'll be really interesting if people not only like the film, but also it starts some sort of conversation.
What made you say yes to it?
Well, just the way it was written, I think that was very, very exciting. I've always been a big fan of Shakespeare's works, and I've read and reread them multiple times, and I've always really, really liked The Merchant of Venice. Mm. And how Vandana had taken that story, The Merchant of Venice, and placed it in school, right, in a way which was very sort of engaging and gripping. What is very interesting in the film is that I'm a drama teacher, right, that is teaching these children Merchant of Venice. And the film also plays out like The Merchant of Venice. Mm. So it's almost like a play within the play, which I think was beautifully written. And the other thing was, of course, the fact that it was a chance to play something that I had not done before, which was an English teacher.
How different was this film for you from your previous films?
See, I've been a child actor. So, I mean, as a kid, it's always about, you know, say your lines and make this sort of an expression. You're told directly what is expected of you.
Correct.
That being said, this was my first like foray into doing something so intense,
right,
and acting as an adult. So when the script came to me, I won't lie, I was nervous, very nervous, and I didn't know how I was going to pull something. I had my reservations, I was pretty scared.
Right.
But then I knew that I wanted to be a part of it somewhere, and while working with Vandana, I mean, I eventually got where I think where I needed to be. We rehearsed the scenes a lot, we workshopped a lot so that everything adds to it and everything makes it better.
Right.
So I think by the time we reached set, there was a certain comfort level, and we both, I mean, there was a comfort level, and it was fun. It was like, it was a part of a process, so it was a lot of fun.
Right, right.
And he's actually, he won the Best Actor Award at
New York.
Oh wow.
For this film.
How was your approach like when you started the film?
So we researched, I mean, I researched it, spoke to boys in all boys boarding schools today, teachers, principals, and certain incidents came up, and we realized that there is still a lot of violence that happens, not every day,
right,
once in a blue moon, but it is quite crazy. However, I will again say it's a movie and it's inspired from Shakespeare, so there is a sense of heightened reality to it, but it is still based on what our imperfect world, as Kunal likes to call it, the world is an imperfect place, and this shows that imperfection.
One reason they should come to theatre and watch the film.
Well, I just, you know, I don't like selling your own film, even though that's what we do during promotions, but I just feel like, you know, the best kind of film is a film that not only sort of engages you, but also, you know, when you leave the theatre, you ask some questions. And I think this is a film that does that, I think.
Do you think it was just a brief fleeting moment that happened in Bollywood? Because the many names that came up, we see those names are back in the business and they are doing the work. Nothing really changed for them.
I do think that it has had some impact in creating awareness and fear in the minds of these perpetrators. Even though, like you're saying, you know, some people have gotten away with it. I do feel like there is a change. I definitely, you know, when I hear conversations around me, I definitely feel like people will not do the things that they were doing before. It might feel like it's failed for the moment, but, you know, every sort of like revolution or change that happens doesn't happen instantly. Sometimes it fails, but then it comes back stronger. So I'm hoping that this movement comes back even stronger.